Hi.
Hi.
So, when did you start acting, actually?
It's since pas très longtemps. C'est pas longtemps. I did my first movie with Cédric Clapiche 2 years ago, or 3, 4. And yes, that. Yeah.
So were you modeling when before that, or?
Yes, I was 15.
And they just came to you, and do you want to act? Was there
no.
a particular inspiration to?
No. It happened as the modeling happened, like that. Et il se trouve qu'avec le film de François, j'ai vécu quelque chose qui fait que je, enfin, j'aimerais continuer, quoi.
It just happened kind of at the same time as the modeling, but what happened with the François's movie, something happened in me that makes me really want to keep forward with it, to go forward with it.
You mean having done it, or the idea of doing it?
The idea of doing it.
L'idée de l'avoir fait, le fait d'avoir fait ce film ou l'idée d'avoir fait ce film?
So did the movie make you want to be an actor more, or did it, is it that you wanted to be an actor and this piece of material came to you?
Est-ce que ce film te donne envie d'être une actrice, ou est-ce que le fait d'être une actrice et que ce film vienne à conforter le fait que tu veuilles?
Non, parce que j'ai jamais eu envie d'être actrice, en fait. Il se trouve que j'ai eu quelques expériences qui me sont arrivées, que j'ai acceptées, qui m'ont rendue curieuse. Et donc, voilà, j'ai été sur, après sur un autre film, et après sur un court-métrage, et après il y a eu le film de François. Et on va dire que que j'ai envie de continuer, mais c'est pas, j'intellectualise pas vraiment ça, en fait. Il se trouve que j'aimerais continuer,
No, I actually never really wanted to become an actress. It's just like it just happened like this out of the experience, and these offers I've accepted made me be curious, and then I kept going with another movie and another short film. Then François's movie happened to come into my life, and then I've decided I really want to keep going into acting. I do not intellectualize this decision at all, but it's just something in me wants to go, to move forward with acting.
So how did you get approached for this? Did Francois come to you? Did you go to a casting call? How did you connect?
Oui, j'ai fait un casting pour le film de François. Et à la suite de ses essais, il a voulu me rencontrer, donc on s'est rencontrés. Et voilà, il m'a évoqué son projet, son histoire, et donc voilà, j'ai décidé de, on a décidé de collaborer, et donc ça s'est passé comme ça.
Okay. I actually went for a casting for François's movie, and after the casting, I did all the tests, and he wanted to meet me, so we met, and he shared the project with me, and I was interested, so we just basically decided to work together.
So how do you go about that work? I mean, you've made a couple things. You don't have a lot of experience as an actress, and you're the lead here, easily, clearly, in this movie. You have a lot to do and a lot of emotion to deal with, or all kinds of range of it. Is that part of what you think he was attracted to in you, is that you were fresh and not
affected? I don't know. You have to ask. Ask to him that. Je sais pas, je crois qu'il a rencontré beaucoup d'actrices, de jeunes filles, et voilà, il a décidé de, enfin, il a eu envie qu'on travaille ensemble, donc après ça s'est passé comme ça, de manière très simple.
Actually, yeah, I think just it's a question you should actually ask François, not me. But what I know is that François had met lots of different young women actresses, but then he decided he wanted to work with me, and it was just very simple.
And how did you actually do the work? Did you guys spend a lot of time discussing the character? Was it instinctual? Were there a lot of takes?
On en a discuté, oui. On en a discuté, mais finalement pas tant que ça. On a fait pas mal de lectures avec les autres acteurs, que ce soit Géraldine Pellas, Frédéric Pierrot, Fantin Rava, le petit frère. Avec Fantin d'ailleurs, on a fait des essais. Il fallait tous les deux. J'ai rencontré pas mal de jeunes garçons aussi. Il fallait que la ressemblance physique fonctionne. Et puis ouais, c'est ça. On a fait pas mal de lectures avec les différents personnages et ça s'est passé de manière assez. On n'a pas véritablement travaillé. On a travaillé un peu sur le costume, si, d'Isabelle. Mais voilà, on a.
We actually discussed, yes, obviously, but not that much. What happened, we actually did lots of reading with the other actors like Géraldine Pellas, Frédéric Pierrot, and Fantin Rava.
The brother.
The one who plays the brother. With Fantin, we did quite a few tests, and I had met lots of other boys, but because we had to make sure that there was a physical match, a resemblance, brother-sister.
Mm-hmm. And, with Géraldine also.
So we actually did lots of reading.
No,
it's okay.
I'm just as a back.
Her instinct is to translate.
We actually just did lots of reading with the different personages. So it's we did not really work on things yet, beside actually working on Isabelle's outfits. Hmm.
So you just instinctually had this character?
Yeah, I mean, I thought about it, but it was more instinctive, way. Ouais.
Instinctive. Yeah. It was more instinctive. She thought about it.
And we did the movie in a chronological way, mm-hmm. So it helps me a lot to build this character. Mm-hmm. But it happened. C'était plutôt instinctif que intellectualisé, en fait.
It was much more instinctual than intellectual as an approach.
So were there many variations on sequences, or were you pretty much going in and getting what you were both happy with? You and the director were both happy with each time.
On a fait des choses un peu différentes, mais comme Isabelle ne parle pas, qu'elle s'explique pas, qu'il y a beaucoup de silence aussi, beaucoup de regards, c'était. On va dire que François savait ce qu'il voulait. Il me demandait un peu d'aller dans telle ou telle direction. Moi, je lui proposais des choses et voilà. Et si ça lui convenait, c'était très bien. Il disait rien. Et puis si ça lui convenait pas, voilà, il me disait un petit peu plus comme ça. Mais on l'a construit. C'était beaucoup dans le travail. On était dans. Oui, c'était très simple comme.
We actually did different things for the different sequences. As for Isabelle's personage, there's very few words. She doesn't explain herself. A lot of it goes through looks and silences and attitudes. And if François knew what I want, I was offering him what I was thinking. He would kind of ask a direction, then I would offer an act. And if he was satisfied, he wouldn't say anything. If he was not satisfied, then we would do more work and build on that work. But it was pretty simple.
Et aussi, on se laisse voler beaucoup de choses aussi. Il y a des choses que j'ai pas forcément maîtrisées et que François a décidé de garder. Mm-hmm.
There's a few things. Le sens de voler, c'est dans le sens de voler, prendre.
Oui, de prendre, mais j'entends par la caméra. Mm-hmm. Elle capte.
Je voulais vérifier. Ouais. There's actually a few things that I feel were kind of robbed between brackets, because there's some things that François would see in my acting that he would keep on the camera, which I actually did not do intentionally.
So you were surprised a little when you saw the movie?
You're always surprised, I think, when you saw a movie.
So do you, was this girl familiar to you conceptually when you read the script, when you first started thinking about doing this?
familière dans le sens où pas vraiment familière. Il se trouve que j'ai eu de l'empathie pour elle dès le début. Donc j'ai eu un fort désir de l'accompagner dans cette histoire.
I was not that acquainted with her, with the the personage, but I felt really lots of empathy for her from the beginning, and I really had a strong desire to start and follow her.
Were you shocked by her choices?
No.
Because it's become rather controversial, as you might have noticed. Some of the media has taken up the cause and feel like somehow this is a male fantasy of a young girl. Is that ring true to you at all, or do you kind of feel like it's been a bit overstated?
Un peu, ouais. Un petit peu. Et puis, c'est... Ça aurait pu être la drogue, ça aurait pu être, je sais pas, l'anorexie, quelque chose de tout aussi violent et pas forcément compréhensible. Il a choisi ça, mais voilà, ça aurait pu être autre chose. Donc c'est pour ça que je trouve que c'est un peu exagéré tout ce qu'il y a eu autour de.
I feel everything that's been said in the media is a little overstated because, you know, her choice was this, but it could have been something else, something people don't really understand, like choosing drugs or becoming anorexic or something like that. But she chose that.
And is it, or is it a? How to put this? Is it a post-feminist thing? I mean, do you think there's a political statement in this movie, or is it just a tale of an individual going through an experience?
Ouais, je crois que c'est ça. C'est pas un film sur la prostitution. C'est pas un film sur je ne sais quel dossier de société. Comme des jeunes femmes qui se prostitueraient pour de l'argent, il se trouve qu'elle, comme on le voit, elle n'en a pas besoin. Elle fait ça véritablement. Je ne crois pas qu'elle sache pourquoi elle le fait d'ailleurs. C'est comme quand je répète encore les mêmes choses, mais quand on se violente un peu, quand on passe par des choses. Oui, violentes, on fait les choses, mais on ne les analyse pas. Après, il se trouve que ça devient son expérience et que. Et qu'elle y trouve des choses, mais oui, François a pas voulu faire un film sur tout ce que les gens ont pu raconter. C'est un film sur l'adolescence, sur ce passage un peu difficile pour certains qui, ouais.
Well, I think François did not want to do a movie on what has been said in the media. He just wanted to make a movie about the teenage years, the coming of age, which is always a difficult period, and it's far from being a movie on what happens in the society or a movie about the prostitution. As we see in the movie, she doesn't need the money, so she's not prostituting herself for money. She actually does not really know why she's doing that, and it's like during these years, like we get violent to ourselves, and there's not really an analysis for her to what she's doing. It's just becoming her experience.
Mm. I think one of the things that offends people is that somehow she isn't destroyed by the experience.
Maybe.
Because I think there's that idea that somehow if you do that, you have to be terribly unhappy.
But this is a movie. That's a movie.
Well, that's just, yeah. I mean, that's the hard part of the conversation.
And maybe the fact that people are telling things, and maybe because there's no answers, we don't know actually.
Well, there are definitely no answers to a teenage girl.
He lets le spectateur avec cette histoire. Et on n'est pas en train, il ne la juge pas et
Yeah, François actually really lets the viewer free, like with the story. It does not, there's no judgment in that movie.
It's an interesting dichotomy because the movie's so popular, or certainly it was at Cannes. You really couldn't get into a screening after the first time it showed. there were, you know, turnaway crowds at all the press of things and the industry things, and yet people were kind of picking at it at the same time. So there's a, like, is this split between people wanting to see it and have the experience and having talking about it afterwards, and kind of the media frowning and going, "Boo, don't do that. That's not safe for you." Odd. So what was the point, what was the thing that you enjoyed the most in the process? What was the thing that made you want to, inspired you to want to act more and do everything else? Was it actually just being on the stage and...
No, c'était le projet en général, enfin le projet dans sa totalité. J'ai beaucoup aimé construire ce personnage et travailler comme on l'a fait. Sur ce temps et puis j'ai envie, enfin je, ouais, je sais pas.
I actually really liked to work on the totality of the project. I liked a lot to build the character and the role, and to work as we have done it and in the timeline that it was filmed. I just felt like that.
Yeah. Oui, c'était vrai, c'était beaucoup de choses. C'est une expérience qui était très riche et ça m'a donné envie de construire d'autres personnages, d'aller vers d'autres histoires.
There were actually lots of things. It was a very rich experience for me, so it just makes me feel like building other roles and characters and work on that.
So is the idea of doing things that are more conventionally made attractive, or is that a different kind of experience that you might want to have, or not as much?
Je sais pas, ça dépendra de ce qu'on me propose. C'est pas moi qui écris les... En tout cas, je ne veux pas tourner pour tourner, j'ai pas envie de jouer pour jouer. Je crois que j'ai besoin d'une rencontre avec un personnage, avec un metteur en scène, avec une histoire, même si c'est pour qu'un tout petit rôle dans un film. Voilà, j'ai besoin de croire, enfin, pas de croire en ce que je raconte, mais en tout cas, j'ai besoin d'avoir cette sensation de d'accompagner un projet. Que j'aime, enfin je...
I think it really depends on the offers I will get. I do not write, and I do not want to make a movie or keep acting just for the fact of acting. I really feel I need to that encounter with a director or a project or a character, even if it's for a small role in a movie. I really believe I need to have that sensation, that feeling in my heart that I go along with a project.
So do you get any of that from modeling?
Est-ce que tu obtiens ces sensations-là d'avoir un projet à cœur quand tu fais une carrière de modèle?
Oh non, c'est différent. Hein. Non, c'est pas pareil. Un rôle comme celui-ci, un projet comme celui-ci, faut le désirer. Enfin, il faut. J'ai pas accepté comme ça. J'y ai pensé avant d'accepter aussi. Mannequinat, c'est encore autre chose. Je peux pas mettre ça sur le même. Sur le même tableau, c'est pas pareil.
No, modeling is not on the same plane at all. It's totally different. Like for a role like this, I felt for a character like this, I felt I really needed to desire playing that person. I really thought a lot of it before I accepted. It's totally different from modeling.
So is modeling a day job potentially? I mean, if you're gonna be wait for great opportunities that are spiritual and, you know, have this kind of weight to them, you're not going to be acting every week of your life. So, I mean, will you continue modeling and kind of do that as something to do, or is it still less interesting to you now?
Le mannequinat, finalement, je l'ai plus ou moins pas arrêté, mais j'ai plus ou moins, depuis pas très longtemps, mais calmé les choses parce que j'ai envie de, encore une fois, si je peux le faire, de choisir les histoires sur lesquelles je vais, ou, sauf quand on fait une promotion pour un film comme ça, où il se trouve qu'il faut faire beaucoup de choses sans forcément choisir. Mais par exemple, il n'y a pas très longtemps, j'ai fait une histoire pour l'Acne Paper. L'Acne Paper, c'est un magazine qui sort très peu dans l'année. Je crois qu'ils font une nouvelle version qui sort une seule fois dans l'année. Mais là, il se trouve que voilà, je créais quelque chose sur chaque image. On avait des perruques, et ça m'a beaucoup plu de raconter quelque chose à travers. C'est totalement différent, mais c'est aussi raconter une histoire à travers un autre support qui est la photographie.
Well, actually, as for modeling, I have not stopped, but I really slowed it down. Not for a very long time, but I did slow it down because I want to choose the projects I'm working on, except obviously when, you know, it's the promotion of a movie, when, you know, I have to do it and it's not a choice. But recently I actually worked on Acne Paper, which is a magazine that's released very little. I think it's just once per year. And that was really interesting because we would actually create for each shot, like using wigs and different outfits. So I really liked the fact of telling again a story through another media support, which is photography.
Enfin, je ne sais pas, je disais l'Acne Paper, mais je dis une fois par an parce que je crois que c'est leur nouvelle version qui sort une fois par an. Ou... Enfin, c'était pour moi, je parlais à haute voix. Okay.
Well, she was just saying basically that for the paper, she was just basically talking to herself, like she thinks it goes only once a year, but it's the new version maybe that she was basically like trying to remember by herself.
So your future may not be your face. You may be behind the camera, you may end up doing, you're interested in being creative, not necessarily being famous or being out there, yeah?
Donc dans ton futur sera peut-être plus que seulement ton visage. Tu peux peut-être te retrouver derrière la caméra ou quelque chose. Ce ne sera pas seulement ton physique en avant et devenir célèbre. Ça sera plutôt faire des choses qui tiennent à cœur.
Non, mais moi, je n'ai pas fait ça pour être célèbre. Non, c'est quelque chose qui m'est un peu... que je tiens à distance. C'est pas du tout un désir. Au contraire, plus loin je me porte de ces choses, mieux je suis. Mais pas forcément derrière la caméra, mais il se trouve que je fais d'autres choses dans la vie. Je fais des choses qui me tiennent à cœur personnellement et qui sont autres que la photo ou le cinéma. Donc oui, je sais pas, je ferai peut-être pas ça toute ma vie.
I actually keep a certain distance with all these things. It was not a real desire to get into it, and the further I stay from these things, the better I actually feel. And I don't know if I'd be behind the camera or anything. It's not my intention, but I also have lots of other things I do in life that are really important for me to do, and it's not only that in my life.
So if Francois called you every 5 years to do something, you'd be happy.
Yeah, but you know, I don't think to the future. I mean, je pense pas. Je pense pas à un plan de carrière ou quelque chose comme ça. Il se trouve qu'on dépend un peu du désir des autres. Là, dans le cinéma, dans tout, même donc. Voilà, peut-être que ça dépendra de ce qu'on me propose
Well, I'm actually not projecting myself or making a big career plan. Really depends on what comes up, and kind of we depend on the desire of other people. So it comes down to, it depends on what's going to be offered.
But it sounds like you want to live. You don't want just to. You're not thinking career, you're not thinking, you don't want to be so vain to suggest that you know what's going to happen, but it doesn't sound, it sounds like you're looking for into experiences, adventure, yeah. life.
This is it, I think. If I mean, this is it, c'est ça.
So acting could be that, or maybe it's not acting, maybe it's something else, maybe it's some combination of things.
Yeah.
So when did you first see the movie?
I saw it the first time. It was not finished at all. Finished, but not. It was a few months after le tournage.
After the shooting.
Yeah. And I saw it later, and after in Cannes.
So were you happier as you saw it, as you got further away from it?
Happier, this is not the word, but I saw the reactions around me of people, and I saw, I can't say so many things about that because it's a bit strange to see yourself in a movie. It's a bit curious, but.
So what are you seeing? Are you looking at your, something you don't like about your ear, or are you looking at your performance, or
no,
is there distance at all?
I was looking at the movie, trying to not see too much me, but the character.
So you've gotten close to that, really seeing the character and not seeing you, or is it still hard to?
J'ai été surprise parce que j'ai réussi un peu à voir le personnage et l'histoire, mais bon voilà, je le mettrai pas dans ma chambre. Enfin, je mettrai pas un DVD dans ma chambre avec le film. Voilà, je l'ai vu 2-3 fois et ça suffit.
I actually surprised myself a little bit because I managed to see a little bit of the movie and the character itself, but I would not lock myself in the room with the movie and watch it over and over. I've seen it 2-3 times and that's it.
And were you happy to have everybody see it? Do you feel exposed at all, or do you feel just like it's a performance like any other movie? And
c'est, je trouve que Cannes rend un film beaucoup plus exposé que enfin, et puis il y a eu tout un truc aussi autour du film, il y a eu beaucoup de presse, les gens en ont parlé, donc ça a été mouvementé comme ça très rapidement en quelques mois, mais bon, ça reste. Il se trouve que c'est la première expérience pour moi d'importante, même si c'est pas, même si c'est pas de manière grave, hein, pas l'importance, mais donc c'est pas rien, mais bon, ça reste un film, et ça reste les médias, donc c'est. Enfin,
For sure, when a movie is shown in Cannes, there's for sure much more exposure, especially with all the hearsay, the people talking, and what has been said in the movie. It's been for sure a little rocky, right? But it's just one experience, even though it's an important experience, and it has not been that heavy or catastrophic as an experience. It's not nothing, but it still stays a movie, or it stays in the media.
But you took your pleasure from doing the work, yeah?
Mm-hmm. Yes, my man.
So there was not, it wasn't really catastrophic at all for you.
No, mais d'ailleurs, je sais pas pourquoi c'est catastrophique.
J'ai dit catastrophique pour traduire mouvementé, rocky. I use catastrophic to interpret something that meant like rocky, like lots of a big turmoil. So mm-hmm. It was not really catastrophic.
In a few months, it happened.
But the turmoil of the press and everything else at Cannes versus your experience, they're two different things for you?
Ah bah ouais, c'est oui, bien sûr. Oui, c'est complètement différent. Il se trouve que pendant 2 mois, j'ai travaillé un personnage et une histoire, et qu'un an après, le film est montré, il ne vous appartient plus, et il a été accueilli d'une sublime manière. Donc tout ce qui va avec.
For sure, it's been totally different, because for 2 months I played for the movie, for the shooting, I played a character, and then the film was shown. That was a year after, so at that time I don't own it. I don't own the character in it, and it's totally different.
And now you get to talk to the press. An absolute pleasure. Obviously, your favorite.
But it's a pleasure. Maybe you don't see it, but you can find some pleasure in that also.
So that's
it's something different.
A philosophy of life for you.
Hmm?
Your philosophy in general, I think, about yourself. To find the pleasure, to find the...
C'est votre philosophie dans la vie de trouver le plaisir, en fait.
Non, c'est pas ma philosophie, non. Mais il se trouve que oui, c'est... Enfin, je... Non, c'est... Ça m'importe d'essayer de trouver du plaisir dans les choses, mais il y a beaucoup de choses qui m'importent. Pas que, mais c'est vrai que c'est important, mais... Il n'y a pas que ça.
finding pleasure in things is not really my philosophy. For sure, it's important to find pleasure, but... There's not only that.
Philosophy. Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.
Merci.
Thank you.